Brian Boerter is here. We're having a lot of fun. He's one of our oldest mates in the industry. But we are having a bit of fun clocking some trends. Yes, we were looking at the boxing trend, but this is a different one. This has been on our bucket list for the longest time, and with good reason. So today is the day we are going to tell you if this recipe is a hit or a hot mess, but it has to be a hit. It's awesome. Okay, so let's show you what we are about to attempt. I stress the word attempt. Take a look.
Batch of dough, which I'll cut up. Into
I can't see.
Some pizza sauce and garlic butter in it, and drop in all my dough. Then I'll slice the pepperoni and mozzarella and into the bowl and mix through. Throw some pepperoni into it, and tip these in. Now I'll cover with cling film
and let rise.
And I get these baked.
Then I make some garlic herb mayo, tip on my bundt cake, and it's beautiful. Sauce in the middle, and it's time to get ripping and dipping. The recipe's in my bio. You can thank me later.
It's easy. It's easy, buddy. We can do this. It. Look, we have simplified the process just a little bit. And yes, ex-pro footballer now, the fitness guru and sideline boxer. You haven't lived until you've been beaten and knocked out by the same guy, yes. Okay? So,
bond of friendship.
We love you, man. In fact, we'll call this the civvy loaf.
Okay? There we go.
So, buddy, you're going to be doing a bit of mixing, and I'm going to be doing a little bit of putting together. But it's basically a beautiful pull-apart bread, and we're using a gorgeous salami. But I love this. Can you imagine for a braai?
Yeah.
With each individual piece that you pull out, it's going to have the flavor and the come
on. It's work. I like what I'm seeing in the moment anyway.
So okay, this is called a carbohydrate. I don't know, can you remember?
It's a slow release energy.
A slow release energy. Okay, so buddy, I'm going to ask you to mix up our sauce and our cheese together, and then I'm going to mix it in here.
I'm using my hands for this.
You can use the spoon. You can do whatever you want.
Am I tossing all of it in?
Actually, it's TikTok. You can do whatever. You can dance while you're doing it. So I've got the salami here, which I'm going to spread around. And we're using the bundt cake tin, which I think is great. So our foodies have obviously taught me that what this allows is because you've got heat coming through the center, it allows for a more even cook, which is quite nice.
Good to know. All right.
Yeah, so you can pass that off as your own intellectual property. That's how I get through the kitchen. I just listen to what the last chef said and then pretend that was my brilliant idea.
Oh, I just got to grab my plate.
Now, actually, dude, you laugh, but through osmosis, I think just by standing next to and working amongst these brilliant chefs, it's just somehow got it into my brain.
Been absorbed.
Oh, I love it, man.
How far am I mixing this? Is this all right for you?
That looks beautiful. Right. That looks absolutely beautiful. And we joke about the boxing, but it's transformed us in that sense. Can you remember? I don't know. You probably had to put on a bit of weight to fight Siv, but have you ever had to cut for a boxing?
I had to cut to fight actually Corneille. Ooh. Corneille was walking around at 94 kgs machine. And I was about 98, 99 at that stage, so I actually dropped weight, and it was a very different dropping weight to putting weight on, to be honest.
Yeah.
Very different. How you eat and how you train.
And you think of those fighters that when they need to be at their peak physical condition, having to cut like that to do 100%. That, to get into that final arena. Okay, so our balls are coming together, probably a little bit bigger. And remember, these will kind of grow and expand. Okay, now we're going to put a little bit of this in and amongst, okay? And that's all going to melt.
Cool.
And it's going to bind all together. I should have had two gloves on.
I feel like that as well, that's...
And this, I mean, we've gone for like a pizza base sauce.
Yeah.
There's nothing stopping you from going onion, maybe.
You can really throw a little extra flavors if you wanted to.
I love it. It's coming together beautifully. I should have done slightly smaller balls. But I think this is going to be amazing, man. And this is a chance to get creative. Have a little bit of
fun. Do we layer this again on top?
Yeah.
Or, okay.
Just put it all in. And this is going to, we could have actually done a bit more. So squeeze that in there. And we're going to add a few more of these guys in and around. And then this goes into the oven, 180 degrees, 25, 30 minutes. And bearing in mind, this is going to be, I think, a bit more doughy, if that makes sense. Not going to be as dry.
Yeah.
But I mean, this is what your life needs, is a pull-apart bread that's going to be more of a showstopper than the meat, man.
Exactly.
Okay. Maybe
cool.
Not the...
I think we've done well there.
It's got one of the three Ps, and by the three Ps, I mean protein, protein, and protein. It's a carb, but it's spectacular. Pop it in the oven, 180 degrees, 25 minutes or so, 25, 30, and you are winning at life.
And then it looks pretty like that afterwards.
It does, and you're going to eat that whole thing. That's going to be your carb load for the rest of the year.
There we go.
Buddy, we love you, man. he's been my physical true north for the longest time, so being able to be in this space with him, absolutely beautiful. And yes, he can cook. And if you want to be able to, well, he can mix. If you want to follow in our footsteps and recreate this yourself, please show us the results. But you can head over to expressoshow.com. com. And if you've got a family recipe, something that we have to try, let's start a new trend. Or maybe it was the first recipe that you learned how to make. We want to know, we want to see it on our socials, and we want to recreate it in this kitchen.